Kilo. First, I wanted to tell you that I feel very, very grateful because I was honored to translate your book, Ask and It Is Given, into Spanish. And I really felt your words whispering on my ears when I couldn't find the right words.
When Jerry and Esther heard that you were the one who was translating the book, they were thrilled. Jerry said, "So nice to have someone doing it who knows the heart of Abraham."
Thank you. And you. Thank you. And every time I was in trouble to find the right words in Spanish, and I asked you for help, I discovered that your Spanish was better than mine. Thank you.
And you also discovered that you are a translator on more than one level.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you. Okay. Question is there such thing as a compassionate God who listens to us and give us what we ask for, even if we don't vibrate sometimes with our desire, or if we are really on our own 100% responsible? In other words, do we have to be happy in order to be happy to begin with? Or can we ask for help when we can't find a thought that makes us feel better? Is there an entity called God that thinks and makes decisions, or is just us all together from which God is made?
Well, that which man calls God is very different from man's image of God, because God has made man, but man is now remaking God in man's image. In other words, man forms a perspective of something and then tries to make everything fit into that, and there is tremendous distortion in that process. You are accurate when you feel that you are that which is God, both from your physical and your non-physical perspective. The combination of you and you and all of the rest of us is what God is, because God is consciousness that is expanding. Sometimes humans feel unsettled about that, because there are so many who have been happier seeing God as just an exaggerated version of man, someone very much like man, but just bigger and hopefully smarter, and with all of the answers. And so in the process of making that image of God, man has subverted his own image of self. In other words, he has humbled himself by making this distinction of this superior God, which makes him the inferior mortal. And on that basis, man has separated himself from that which is God, which is sort of a self-fulfilling prophecy, isn't it? People have said to us in gatherings like this, "Abraham, you have disrupted my image of God." Some have even said, "Abraham, you do not talk of God much, and I want to know why that is." And we said, "We don't talk of anything other than what you call God." In other words, we are that energy. You are that energy. We are all in this together, but we certainly acknowledge that it is not easy to see the big picture from the physical format, but it is easier and easier to feel the big picture from the physical format. In other words, when you, through your appreciation of another or of a flower, find a vibration that puts you in alignment with that which is source energy, so that you are that energy, when there is no separation between the energy that is God and who you are in that moment, then you have knowledge of that. In other words, under those conditions, you don't question so much. Usually when people are questioning their relationship with God, it's when they have gotten themselves into a vibrational quagmire where they are far vibrationally from the energy that is that. And it's so interesting. Do you know the majority of prayers that are offered from physical humans is from a place of utter disconnection of that which they are hoping to receive? And so man, in his effort to pray and receive guidance, actually enhances his separation between who he really is and the God that he is reaching for. Jerry and Esther have a dear, dear friend who is a minister, has been a minister of more than one church, different denominations, and says to his congregation on a rather regular basis, "I used to pray for God, but he was always out to lunch." And we say, you must be in vibrational alignment before you know that which you are reaching for. And when you are in vibrational alignment, the lack of separation is something that you know viscerally. You know vibrationally, not so much intellectually. And then, of course, to be in sync with that energy and feel infinite intelligence pouring through you. In time, you have all answers to all questions. And the first question we want you to ask is, who am I? And our answer is, you are God. And the next question we want to hear from you is, and how am I doing? And the answer that we want you to hear is, you are doing exceptionally well. You are right on track. And the next question we want you to ask is, how can my life be better? And we say, seek things that feel good to you when you focus upon them. And the next question that we want you to ask is, how am I doing? And the answer is, exceptionally well. And the next question we want you to ask is, what will come next? And we say, whatever it is you choose. And the next question that we want you to ask is, well, will you not choose for me? And the answer is, we are choosing with you, but we are not choosing for you. And when you are in vibrational alignment with that which is us, the choices that we make together are those choices that we all intended when you made the decision to come forth into this physical body to begin with. It's closing the gap, solving the separation, becoming one with who you are in your joyous endeavor, and then being the God in physical form that is natural to you. You have glimpses of that as you were translating that book. You were in vibrational alignment with that. You know that power. Esther feels it as she feels us pour through her. She knows that she is in alignment with that which is Source. And she revels in the feeling of ecstasy as the words fly from her. In other words, there's no question in her mind that she's in vibrational alignment with infinite intelligence, or God, if you want to call it that. She can feel the power of it and the clarity of it and the goodness of it and the love of it, you see. But words don't teach. You have to have your own personal experience in order to have that knowing. And that's why every word that is uttered through Esther, that is offered from us, is a word and now translated by you to help others understand that you are the creator of your own reality. You are the God that is the creator of worlds, you see. Don't be humble and try to make yourself apart from that. Embrace it and accept it and ride that wave. Yes.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.